Alright, what's up guys? I got the Pilatus PC24 today from MSgier for xplane 11. I've seen this jet for a few months, but haven't picked it up. Mainly because it's actually brand new from Pilatus in real life. And I actually just watched a video earlier on it. They've been certified and are delivering the first 85 aircraft, I think, next year. So because of it being so brand new, I was initially apprehensive as to how accurate the flight model could be in this xplane 11 version. So I'll get to that more in a second, but for now, let me say that so the BizJet market for xplane 11 is kind of limited. You got the Challenger 300, which many of you are aware of and you've seen in my videos a couple times, and then you also have the Hawker 4000 available. I forget who made that. It's on xplane.org. So those are the two main high-quality ones available right now. There's a few other low-quality and freeware. Well, I say low-quality, but I mean, they're decent aircraft. There's the Gulfstream 4, which is a freeware aircraft, and I think there's a Lear on the org store. So other than that, there's few options. So then there's also this PC-24, which... So, you know, I have the Challenger 300. I wanted another BizJet. I've been loving the MSgier PC-12. I've been happy with it, as you've probably seen by my many videos of it. So I was like, hey, you know what? It's the same maker, MSgier. I'm like, let me try their PC-24. So I took the plunge today, $25. And so this is my review. It's about the same quality visually. It's got a few more liveries. The cockpit is very similar, and that's another thing I wanted to mention was with this new PC-24 that Pilatus is making, the cockpit is so similar to the PC-12, and it reminds me of the conversion perhaps that Cirrus is trying to do between the SR-22 and the Vision Jet, making the cockpit almost identical. That way it makes a transition from the one aircraft to the next easier, like for example going from the SR-22 to the Vision Jet, or going to the PC-12 to the PC-24, even though it's you're going from a piston to a jet, or you're going from a turboprop single to a twin jet. But having that same flight deck makes it easier transition. So that's what they're going for with this Pilatus. So it's got the G1000 here. Yeah, all that is pretty similar. So now I'm going to point out the fact that the gauges on this, well, first let me start, the starter and the ignition is hard to click. I had a hard time getting it to start. I'll put this part in. I don't know if I was just not pulling it the right way, but that's one note. Another note is the gauges on this plane. It's showing low oil pressure or high oil pressure at what should be normal throttle, and then the other gauges, such as the manifold pressure and the RPM, doesn't move. They're stayed pinned at the top. So basically the only gauge that I can go by is the fuel flow, and so that was a little annoying. I don't know. And then that's another reason why I waited to get this, is because I had a feeling that the data would be limited. There's only 85 of these aircraft being delivered. They're even yet to be delivered. So when MSgier made this, I have a feeling that they were limited on the data they could use, as opposed to the PC-12, which has been out for so long. You could probably round up a pilot to give you info or test it. Whereas this, you know, they probably were just using basic general dynamics, and it's not accurate to what the actual plane is. Which leads me to my next thought is, it seemed like it accelerated unrealistically fast. You'll see that on the runway when I take off. Like, again, I don't know. The only thing I can compare it to is the Challenger 300, and it seemed really fast compared to that. I was at 3/4 gross weight, so again, this is just my input. So one other thing I'll say about this plane is it's pretty easy to fly. Low stall speed, even the real aircraft, and they have it modeled here, 80 knots stall speed. So that means you can get into shorter airstrips and land slower and shorter. So that's one thing worth pointing out about this plane. So, all right, that's really all I got. I tried to include as much information as I could. I know in my previous videos, I kind of just do a short review, which I still like that style because it's easy to find YouTubers that will give every last detail, which there's nothing wrong with that. I think that's good, but mine are more geared to like a fast, get the gist of it, and basically you could see in the B-roll for yourself how it's going. So, all right, y'all, check it out the next video. Reach out, touch faith. Takes a couple of bands, put me to